Hey folks, Crazy Clamor 80 here again. And it's time we're going to look at game number 19 in my 20 from 1987 series. And this is part of the storied Pac-Man franchise. This is the first game to be presented in 3D. And this is called Pac-Mania. And this was created by Namco and licensed to Atari in the U.S. Not licensed to Midway or Bally Midway. This game gives you a jump button, which was present in Pac-Land before, but this is a 3D version of the standard Pac-Man game, and I really like the look of this. This was licensed to Atari in the U.S., not Midway or Bally Midway, because they're Namco's contractual obligation with Midway ran out, and they didn't want to renew, because Midway had ripped off the Pac-Man franchise for a number of games without Namco's consent. So they went with Atari this time. Yeah, the look of this is very nice. Pac-Man is in 3D. The ghosts are in 3D. The maze is in 3D. There's some very cool-looking mazes, and note that they are so big that they scroll as you move left or right and up and down. And that's not new. That was in Junior Pac-Man, where the screen would scroll left and right. And that was one of the games that Midway ripped off the Pac-Man franchise without Namco's consent. And you can, in the American version, you can stage select, or you can select one of the harder stages and get a bonus for completing a maze. I love the music in this game. It is fantastic. Don't completely fall in love with the jump function. You can accidentally jump too late and still be nailed by the ghosts. One thing you'll definitely want to notice is that there's more than just four ghosts at a time in the maze. There are your usual bonus fruits that appear in the center of the maze, but there are also some special items. And the special items basically are two. There is a pink pellet and a green pellet. The pink pellet will allow you higher bonuses for eating the ghosts. And the blue pellet will make Pac-Man move faster. Whereas the points for eating ghosts is normally 200, 400, 800, 1600, then 3200, and then 7650, which is Namco's special number. I don't know why the music goes weird there. But normally I like the music in this game. That bonus point power from the pellet, the pink pellet, lasts until you die. With the pink pellet power, the ghosts are worth 400, then 1600, and then 7650. And the ones after that are also 7650. And we have these funny little cutscenes, intermission scenes like we had in the original Pac-Man, but they look a little different here. Yeah, I really love the presentation. Apart from the jump and the speed up and the bonus points for the ghosts and the fact that there are more of them, plus later on in the game there will be jumping ghosts. This is still basically the same Pac-Man as the original. There will be some special bonus fruits that will appear in the center that aren't your normal fruits, and they will also give bonus points. And these will be like green apple, coffee, chocolate ice cream cone, and vanilla ice cream cone. You get some nice bonus points from the from those special foods. But yeah, there are more than just four ghosts on the screen at once, and they will often be copies of the other ghosts. But I love that you can control the movement of Pac-Man in the middle of his jump. You can pull him backwards, or move him forwards, move him all around. Whoops, I jumped too late. You can jump too late in this game, and you can be tagged by the ghosts. Just have to time your jump. Just get a feel for how long it takes for Pac-Man to land from a jump. Yeah, you can turn corners as you're in midair, which is very nice. And note that the ghosts respawn in the center pen, like they did in the original Pac-Man. It almost looks like you can go into the ghost pen, but you cannot. Now, there are differences between the US version and the Japanese original of Pac-Mania. The main ones, the US version has less levels. There are the difficulty stages, which have multiple rounds. There is Easy, which has Block Town, and I love the Lego look of Block Town, or at least the first stage. Then there is Medium, and that is Pac-Man's Park. And there is Hard, and that is Sandbox Land. And then which you cannot select from the beginning is super hard, and that is called Jungly Steps. But the US version has less levels, and the ghosts that can jump, there will be ghosts later that can jump, and they jump when Pac-Man jumps. They will appear sooner in the Japanese version. There is no top 10 scoring list in the Japanese version, as there is in the US version. And I don't think you can select your stage or your difficulty like you can in the US version. You can't in the Japanese version. And I think that's just about it for the differences. I remember seeing this, I think, first at a movie theater, in the movie theater lobby. We will do a regular playthrough, and then we will see at least snippets of the remaining stages. And in those... See, you can use some trickery to get around the ghosts. Later on, I will put on invincibility. Cute little intermission scenes. But yeah, I like the layout of the stages. Whoa, that's close. Get me some nice bonus points. But yeah, whoa. When you have the pink pellet power, where you can get all those bonus points for eating the ghosts, it'll last until you die. So you can just keep on getting bonus points for eating the ghosts after you get the power pellet. If you've never... Whoop! There I ran into the jumping ghosts. The jumping ghosts are green and gray. And they are called, like, Funky and Spunky? I think that's correct, yeah. Funky is green, and Spunky is gray, and Spunky can jump higher than the green one. If you've never played Pac-Man, I'm sorry, you might not understand what I'm talking about when I'm talking about the gameplay here. Oops. But go play the original and then play this. You might get kind of confused by how the gameplay works. But in the original Pac-Man, you try to eat all the dots in a maze, and certain big dots, and there are four of them, will allow you to turn the table on the ghosts, and you can eat them for a short time. But you just want to clear all the dots, and sometimes there's special bonus prizes in the center of the screen. And that's how Pac-Man works, or Pac-Mania works. You can continue, but you will have to start at the beginning of the maze that you lost your last life on. This has cute music. We will look at snippets of the remaining stages, and I apologize that the sound effects might not be synced up correctly. But we saw that there is a pink pellet that sometimes appears in the center that will give you those extra bonus points for eating the ghosts, which are normally 200, then 400, then 800, then 1600, then 3200, and then Namco's special number 7650. But with the pink pill, they are 400, then 1600, then all the way up to 7650. So if you got a lot of ghosts, like, I don't know, 8 or 9 or something or more, then you can maybe get the maximum, and then continue to get the maximum if you can eat a lot of ghosts. So you can really start racking up the points. But yeah, I put on invincibility to show you the later areas. And we are now on the jungly steps. And that little striped awning in the middle is where the ghost's pen is. And it looks like you can go across there and you cannot. But we will look at these remaining stages here. Yeah, there's only one... was it just one stage of the block town? And then like a two or three stages of medium and hard. And then once you've played all the stages, or all of the settings, then you will have to play them again. Ooh, there's a Galaxian prize. But we will see snippets of me playing the remainder of the stages, and there's the original Lego-colored stage that we saw the first time around, but this is the second time around. You have to play the stages through twice. Oh, that's a weird color pattern for the Legos. And here was Pac-Man's Park. I think that's what this was called. Yeah, this is the medium difficulty here. But once you play all the stages or all the areas through the second time, then you will have beaten the game, and the game will end. And like I was saying, there are more stages in the Japanese original than in the American version. There's like one more stage for each setting, or each block, or whatever you want to call it. But there is Block Town, and it's the Lego-like setting, and then there is Pac-Man's Park with those. With those 3D walls, and then there is Sandbox Land, and then lastly there are the Jungly Steps. I don't know why they call them Jungly Steps. It's weird. And again, I apologize for the non-syncing of the sound effects or music here. Sometimes when you record with Bandicam, if you chop it up for, like, after your gameplay, like I do, just to show snippets of the later stages, then sometimes there are sync problems. But listen for that. There was a black key that you get bonus points for? There are interesting different prizes, special prizes, The usual prizes that appear are cherry, strawberry, orange, apple, bananas, and peach, and bell, and key. But there are special prizes that can appear, like candy, a green apple, coffee, a chocolate cone, and a vanilla cone. And then there are those two pellets that you can collect that can give Pac-Man special abilities. And these are the jungly steps. I don't know why they call them jungly steps. That's weird. But, yeah, the green pellet will give you faster Pac-Man, and the pink pellet makes the ghosts worth a lot more when you eat them, and both powers last until you die. But yeah, this is the second time through, so once I beat the jungly steps, then I'll have beaten the game. Yeah, this color pattern I don't really care for. It's really, really loud pink. But yeah, there are two ghosts that can jump, and they will jump when Pac-Man jumps. And they are green, and that is Funky. And there is gray, and that is Spunky, and Spunky will jump higher than the other ghost, and he can jump as high as Pac-Man. Well, that was Pac-Mania, and that is the... Boy, I lost count. It's probably like the fifth or sixth Pac-Man game. It's a worthwhile sequel, worth picking up. I don't like it as much as Pac-Man or Ms. Pac-Man or even Super Pac-Man. But it's definitely worth checking out. It's definitely got good music, cute 3D graphics, enough quirks to make it worth checking out. And I'll put in my initials here. I screwed up. I accidentally put in Q. So I just put in whatever. Q-U-F or something. But at any rate, that's Pac-Mania. That was game number 19 in our 20 from 1987 series. Well, I thank you for watching Pac-Mania, created by Namco and licensed to Atari in the U.S. That was game number 19 in our 20 from 1987 series, and I hope to see you soon for game number 18. Y'all have a great weekend, and I will see you later. Bye-bye, folks.